The year 2020 has been the most unique and unpredictable in modern history. Collectively as a race, we have seen huge changes in almost all facets of life. Most people worldwide suffered unimaginably at the hands of the lockdown, both mentally and financially. Many businesses were shut down, jobs were lost, leaving pretty much everyone with a sense of uncertainty, anxiety, and fear about what the future holds. More than any other thing, it all became about survival. The COVID pandemic was an experience no one would wish upon their worst enemies, yet we all went through it. In life, things happen, and they're often out of our control. It's taken a huge toll in terms of time, resources, and precious human lives. But with every tragedy we face, we come out stronger and wiser on the other side. There are things to be learned. A huge takeaway for most people living paycheck to paycheck is that this no longer serves as a viable option. Jobs are not as stable as we thought they were. Most people are merely a few paychecks away from going broke. Then you have to ask yourself the question, how long would you survive on the money you've already accumulated if you didn't work? For most people, the answer is no more than a few months. Suppose you were laid off at work today. How long would it take you to find another job? Hiring rates are low too. You should listen closely to the points we're about to tell you then. Now before we begin, give this video a like, don't forget to subscribe, and share this video with your friends who could probably also benefit from this advice. First of all, you must educate yourself and learn about the difference between active income and passive income. Active income is that which is earned through your 9-to-5 job or an enterprise you run. Time and effort go into this. You need to be physically present and involved. Passive income comes from your investments and other things. Your physical labor isn't required here for you to make a profit. Your attention is required at times, but that's as far as it goes. It doesn't take nearly as much time as your active income. Here, you are leveraging on systems that are more or less founded on the labor of others. A good first step would therefore be to look at these two forms of income and find ways to make them grow more profitably. You can find other types of active income, but also think about how to create a channel of passive income. Step one involves boosting your own potential. This means investing in yourself too. You need to put in the effort and money to acquire a new skill. To learn any valuable skill, you need to put in the hours. Starting any new business idea without being equipped with the right skills is a recipe for disaster, and you are ultimately going to crash and burn in failure. For example, if you hope to start a blog, you're going to have to first polish your writing skills and learn how to make engaging content that will bring you traffic. It also helps to work on your social skills, for we know that many times it's not through merit that people get ahead, but through charming their way in and out of situations. Step two is to monetize. Consistently keep in mind that you're doing this to add on to your income. Find the best ways to make money from the skills you've learned. Many great artists and singers die without having their names heralded. Not because of a lack of talent, but the lack of marketing skills to get themselves ahead. Do your research while devising your game plan. Look at other people who achieve success in similar ways and learn from them. If you need ads for your service or product, it's essential to add the cost of that to your selling price. This is how you'll reap a profit and get a good return on your investment. You'll have to also be careful and avoid any unnecessary expenditure. If you hold a stock or some property that's making you lose money, don't be hesitant to give it away. This will be better for you in the long term. And step three is to effectively use technology. As you no doubt must have seen, the businesses that not only survived but expanded during the lockdown were those that managed to properly leverage technology. There was a huge shift and everything became online. Many people began ventures based on the internet, and many of them have grown and proved very profitable and successful. There is no better time than today to create an online presence for your business. Plan out your activity in a way that requires minimal physical presence. Get lots and lots of publicity to your pages on social media. This will create visibility for your startup and bring in traffic. You might also generate extra income if there's enough traffic on your website and pages. If you need to employ people to ensure the smooth running of your online presence, make sure to use remote workers as much as possible. This will save you a lot of costs. You can use remote freelancing sites such as Fiverr and Upwork to get your work done without making too many commitments. Number one, online courses. You can create online courses. It could be something as simple as teaching yourself how to drive, to cooking, to teaching a foreign language that people might be interested in learning. Upload your content on appropriate websites such as Skillshare and make money. You can even make a WhatsApp group and charge a registration fee for joining, where you share tutorials and tips on your selected niche. Number 2, blogging. You can create an online domain for yourself and your startup through blogging. But we can't stress enough the importance of selecting the correct niche. If you choose something you're well informed about, it'll be easier for you to run things and develop content. It's good to identify the problems and needs of your desired demographic first, then come up with content that tackles that. The more traffic you bring in, the more money you'll make. Affiliate marketing is all about helping product creators market their goods with a commission involved. If you've come up with a brand new product that solves a current problem and is in high demand, you can get in touch with your seller and compromise on a set commission. The best way to get into affiliate marketing is to register on an agency website like Warrior Plus and ClickFunnels. Number 3, dividend stocks. Dividend-paying stocks are also a good way to generate passive income. Determine how much money you can afford to lose in this gamble and invest in stocks. It wouldn't hurt to get a second opinion and seek some professional advice for guidance. Identify companies that pay out dividends consistently. The company you choose should preferably have a record of stability in growth and company policies that assure your payoff. Dividends are paid quarterly, biannually, or yearly. You can reinvest your earnings partially or fully, too. Number 4, book publishing. You can also write a book. You can put your thoughts and history together and create a book that would help people and impart wisdom. If you're good at writing, you can even try your luck at writing fiction. Also remember that there are probably things you know that others don't, and that shouldn't be taken for granted. You may be really talented too. Number 5, start a YouTube channel. Starting a YouTube channel is another viable option. Post videos that add value to people's lives. Two important things that will determine the fate of this venture is the originality and quality of content that you churn out, and how efficiently you market said content. If your content is informative and entertaining, you'll bring in subscribers, and then the money-making begins. You can earn money through YouTube ads and brand endorsements. And number 6, social media influencer. People use their social media presence to create a persona for themselves, and this popularity then brings in money. Similar to the YouTube channel, you'll bring in money through brand endorsements and deals and advertisements. You already probably spend a great deal of time on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, so why not do it and make something out of it too? You can start creating a fan base today. The more specific your niche, the better. Now that you've seen the various ways you can generate a passive income for yourself and secure a more profitable financial future for yourself, there's nothing stopping you. Plus, all the options that I just mentioned are about passive income. We'd advise you to not jump the gun and quit your office job just yet. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. We hope we were able to teach you a thing or two. Don't forget to leave a comment down below letting us know what you thought of today's video. Until next time.